Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Commander Keen. Today, I guess we're gonna come up here and see what's what. We've still got, I don't know, assuming I have to fill that, it looks like maybe five more wise men. I think they might have told me how many there were at the beginning, but I wasn't paying attention, because why would I do that? We're entering the Crystalis, which is also an incredibly difficult Nintendo game. Those of you who have played it, I'm sure, will remain scarred by the poison in the early game, whereby you would get poisoned. Oh my god, just die. You would get poisoned and it was, you couldn't survive it in the early game. It was a death sentence. You were better off just resetting your console and starting all over again. They did re-release it, actually. Oh, I was robbed. They did re-release Crystalis on, the Game Boy Color, I believe it was. And they kind of retweaked it there, and that was the first time I ever beat it. You guys kill me. Yes, you do. Okay. I think those don't kill you on contact. I think it's their breath weapon that'll kill you. I'm gonna test that here. In just a moment. Yeah, okay. I kind of dig that there are some enemies that won't kill you on contact. Is this spiked death? No. Alright. So they're giving me rings of chocolate bars and firearms. As well as jerk slugs that poop acidic death all over the place. That sounds like a proper D&D monster right there, but no, instead we get the flail snail. Acid shitting slugs, I think. What the fuck was that? Oh my god. This game. Alright, I do want to see what's over here. See about maybe. Can we shoot up? Oh, yes, we can. Alright. That's right, you fucker. Come over here. Huh? Oh! Oh! We just got schooled. I do have to say that the difficulty in this one. To me, the difficulty in this game feels really good. Like, it feels like, I don't know. It feels right, I guess. I don't know how else to say it. It ain't bad. Like, it rewards you for, you know, not being a raging jackass. Alright, so can I just, like, I think I just, yeah. Oh, I didn't kill it. Oh, maybe I. Okay, that's what I thought. I was like, because I heard that we hit the fucking bird, but we only stun it. Oh, that's horrible. I hate that. We've found an enemy that our guns can only wound, but not kill. Don't tell me that thing is, like, smart enough to come up and around. No, alright. That feels just gross. Alright, out of ammo, I think we need 160,000, Jesus. This is also freaking gross. Is there anything else? Oh no. Oh, this is the worst thing. And then all they need is like an acid slug up here because fuck you, that's why. Acid slug. Ah! Ah! Oh! That one's not too bad. These, I think, yeah, it's just to give me. Oh. Alright, so what's. I think there's a slug over here. We've got killer buzzy beetles. Come on, elevator. Come on, fuck you! Could I have killed that thing? Yes. Oh, interesting, there's no gun here this time. It would appear, I think this gun only spawns. Yeah, let's find out. I think this gun only spawns if you have less than 5 ammo. Kill me. Yeah! I noticed that it spawned, I don't know, a couple deaths ago. Yes, that was intentional. I'm gonna reload. Cause. Yeah. But no, I'm quite liking the levels in this. They're... God, what's the word I want to use? I'm not going to use, like, punishing, but you can tell that it was kind of designed with maybe a little bit of expectation that you were going to be saving as you went, because there's, like, a lot of nasty stuff in here. Like, now I know I don't want to go too far right, or we're going to aggro that dick bird. But it's weird coming back and playing this after having previously played the old Keen games, where levels were, I guess, designed with the expectation that you get through them in one run. Whereas this seems like they kind of are like, yeah, you might get through this in one run, but you're probably not going through, and instead you're going to die horribly. So you should probably save, you stupid ass. So yeah, we're gonna start doing that, I guess. Good old save that, wrong button. Good old save scumming. Okay, I'm gonna kill that thing. Kill that thing. Alright, is there anything up there? Maybe. There's some. I can see a platform off to the left. Alright, Buzzy Beetle. Can't kill him. I don't like those things. Oh, they're giving me some ammo, though. Alright. I wonder if I can pogo jump up to that ledge over there. Because I think I need to pogo jump off of this one to the left, but that is, like, so hard to do. Oh, no, there's just, like, some pickups over there. Alright. Nope. Oh, that was stupid. God damn it. That was a stupid fall right there. Alright. I don't know where I stand on the music. It's not bad. It could certainly be worse. But I don't know if I'm sold on it being good. Because, I mean, this was early 90s, so let me think. What do you have to compare this to? See, Doom was 93, which is after this, I believe. I don't even know. Like, I'm trying to think about, like, old RPGs that I've played. I'm like, Eye of the Beholder? Maybe, I think that was 89, but that game had, like, all of 2 music tracks in it, so I don't know. Okay, green key. No falling death. Okay, so where the hell do we need this? I'm gonna save. Because I think the one that's way up in to the right, I think that was a red one, so maybe this is the one on the bottom left. By the dick bird. No, that's blue. Was it? Oh, fuck off. No. Wrong way. There we go. Oh, come on, game. Oh, wait, that thing jumped up here. Alright. Nice. I don't know how comfortable I am with this fucker being up here. But I don't exactly have much choice. I saw this thing just a moment ago. I don't know what's gonna lead us to. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, this actually wasn't as horrible as I had expected. I am still going to save because if nothing else, I am a bleeding coward. Alright. Well, there's the yellow key. I keep having to remind myself that I can walk over the part of these poles where there's a hole. I'm fully expecting to fall through it. Can I Yes, okay. Oh, there's the blue crystal right down there. I have no idea. My thinking is that if we go this way, this is going to maybe loop around and get us to the yellow... Oh! A donut! 2,000 points worth of calories. Alright, I'm gonna save before we do this, just in case that this is one of those, like, cheeky, haha, you, like, missed it by a pixel fall traps here. I don't think it is. Okay, it wasn't. Just making sure. This game has conditioned me not to trust. Oh! I would have been so fucking petulant, you guys. Okay, so we need yellow now. I think that's the one that's up here. Maybe? I don't know. We'll poke around. Fuck you, bird! Okay, there's some ammo, which I actually don't really need at the moment. I will, however, remember that it is there. Okay, yeah, this is red, which we do not have. Trying to think. Oh, damn it. That was my own fucking fault. I knew that thing was there. Could you imagine trying to do this all in one go? I mean, I'm sure there's some madman out there who can run through, like, this entire game without dying, and, you know, good for him, but... Shit. For us mere mortals... We gotta get mail on this one. This game won't even see him coming. Alright, here's the yellow one. Oh, fuck you, you... Little buzzy beetle just sitting there waiting with pure killing intent. Man, imagine what being on a pogo stick would do to you from that height, like landing. Like, oh, I don't even want to think about it. Suffice it to say, it probably wouldn't be pleasant. Okay, so that was, yep, up here. Oh, fucking goddamn it. No! Can I? Ooh, an idea. Do I care enough to? I just like regular. Oh, look at that. Cheeky fucking game. Oh, and I know what you fuckers are. Yeah, you're expecting me to like super jump across all this, aren't you? God, that is so hard to do. Alright, last try, because I don't want to spend the entire episode trying to do this. Yeah, there's like a little bit of like ledge catching assistance there, but it's not enough. Okay, so what do we need? We need the blue one. The red one's on the right side of the map. Actually, we have to go under a little bit further here. Right this way. All right. I hope the music isn't driving you guys insane. I'm actually kind of tuning it out. Perks of having a younger brother. Like, growing up, is you get really good at just, like, completely ignoring any loud screeching sounds, as well as pleads for mercy and whimpers. Older brothers will understand. Alright. So what shenanigans- oh, I was gonna say, what shenanigans are you guys gonna make me do to get this key, and... The game was merciful, and I don't like it. What is this? This isn't the keen that I've come to fear. We are nearing on an extra life, though. Now we just have to get past this fucking asshole bird and we'll be done. And I'll be able to call this. It's looking like we're gonna be just doing, like, a level an episode, which I'm okay with, actually. Oh. Oh, there's more. I was expecting we would be near done here. 2, 3... God, I don't like those things. Like, they're a non-threat. Unless you, like, fall on one of them or something. But I just don't like timing jumps in, like, old game. Edge of map. Y'all better watch out. There's the edge of map under us. Fuck, oh shit, it was an ambush. Fuck, come here, old guy. We're getting out of here.
Oh, thank you so much for rescuing me. I'll return to the Oracle Chamber immediately.
You know, you look a lot like the last guy I rescued. Keen thumbs up, TM. Whew. I mean, that overall wasn't too bad. That having been said, I think I am going to go ahead and call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you all had a good time. And I will see you all next time, wherein we're going to be tackling something else in the frigid Northlands here. Until then.